Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am explaining you the concept of binary search tree. In this video series, I have explained the concept of introduction, representation and operations that can be performed on a binary search tree. Then we have seen the create and insert operation with two different solved examples. Then we have seen the search operation for successful search and unsuccessful search. The last video was about the delete operation on the first solved example, and now in this current video I am explaining you the same delete operation with second solved example. After that we will cover the display operation on the two solved examples. So let's start with the content of binary search tree. For all the contents of the binary search tree and the data structure, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Let's start with the basics of binary search tree. The binary search tree is a special kind of binary tree which exhibits a special behavior or a characteristic. For every node, if it is a left child, then it is having a value which is less than its parent node, and every node, if it is a right child, then it must have a value which is greater than its parent node. So for your reference, I am providing you one example of the binary search tree. Let's start with the operations that can be performed on a binary search tree, and here we are focusing on the delete operation. And let's start with the delete operation on a binary search tree. So what is delete operation? The delete operation will help you to delete a particular key from the constructed binary search tree. And to perform the delete operation, you're supposed to start from a root node and you have to perform the search operation to search the delete key. If the delete key found, if it is present, then we have to take care of three different cases which will be helpful to perform the delete operation. And if the key is not found, then there is no any meaning to perform the delete operation. So let's see which different three cases we supposed to handle while performing the delete operation. This is the first case, where if the node which you want to delete is a leaf node, then what the steps we supposed to follow? The second case is if the node which we want to delete is having a single child, then what we have to do? And the node which we want to delete is having its both child nodes, that will be the case number 3. Here we have to take care of, if it is a leaf node, then it's very simple case. But if it is having a single child node or both child nodes, then we supposed to take care of its child node before performing the delete operation. See, it's related to your real life example. If any of the member of our family is not exist, then we have to take care of the child's of that particular member. In the same way, we have to take care of the child nodes. It may be a single child node or it may be a both child node. So we have to take care of that child nodes before performing the delete operation. I have already explained the first solved example in my previous video, and now let's start with the second solved example. See, this is the constructed binary search tree with us, and now let's start to perform the delete operation. Suppose if my search key is 15, let's first of all search for a node 15, and here you can see that this is the node 15, and you can observe the thing is like 15 is a leaf node. So it goes under the first case, delete a leaf node. Let's search the node starting from the root node. So compare it with root node 52, then 24 as 15 is less than 52. Compare with 24 as 24 is greater than 15 or 15 is less than 24. Let's move to the left subtree or left child 18. Compared with 18, 15 is less than 18. Let's move to the left child 12, but greater than 12. Let's move to the right subtree. And now both the values are equal. So now we have reached up to the node which we want to delete. Now here, as it is a leaf node, we don't want to perform any further things, because this is a leaf node, there is no any dependency. Directly we will delete the node and your tree will look like this. Now let's move forward for the second case, which is nothing but let's compare or let's accept the key value from a user. It is 65. Here you can see that 65 is having a single right child node. This single right child is having again a subtree. We have to take care of all the things with respect to the right child. Let's see what the steps we have to follow. So first of all, let's see, it goes under the second case with a single child node. Let's start for the comparison. Compared with 52, greater than 52, move to the right child 86. Compare with 86, less than 86, so that's why I move to its left child. And here you can see that both the nodes are equal. So our search is successful, and after that we can see that this is goes under the case number 2, where we have to take care of its child node 79. So this is the node which we want to delete. Then after that, what we have to do, we have to replace the child node, whatever it may be, a left child or a right child. In this case, this is a right child. What we have to do, we have to replace this node with the to be deleted node, and your tree will look like this. So let's replace the value and your tree will look like this. As 79 is less than 86 and it secured a correct position as a left child of 86. So in this way we can perform the case number 2. And now let's move to the next case. Let's accept the key value from a user. Say it is 86. For 86, we will check that for 86 it is having both the child nodes, so hence it will fall under case number 3, where case number 3 is dealing with delete a node with both children. So in this case, what the steps we supposed to follow? First of all, we have to take care of the two different ways with which we can perform the delete operation with both the child node. The first case is we have to take care of the in order successor. We have to replace the node which we want to delete with the in order successor. So let's start with the first of all, search a delete key, starting with the node 52 as a root node. Compare it with 52 as 86 is greater than 52 and a right child is present to 52. Step down to the right child, and here you can see that the delete key value is equal to the current root node. So we have searched with the delete key. Now the next step is to find out the in order successor, as we have to use the technique or the way one to perform the delete operation of the node which is having both the children. So which one is the in order successor? For this you must know the in order traversal of the tree, and here you can see that the in order successor is nothing but the 91. So what we have to do, we have to replace the delete key with the in order successor. So let's replace the delete key with in order successor, and here we have done with the in order, here we have done with the deletion of a node which was having both the child nodes. Now let's move forward for the second way with which we can perform the operation of the deletion of the node. So let's accept the key from a user. It is 86, and here you can see again that the 86 the same example just as of the previous is having both the child nodes. So first of all, let's find out the case. It falls under case number 3, and now here we are going to take care of in order predecessor, which was the way number 2. In the previous slide, we have seen the first way for the deletion of node having both the child nodes, which was in order successor. Now let's move forward for the in order predecessor. So let's search for a deletion key. Let's start with the root node. As the key value is greater than root node and right child is present to the root node, step down to the right child and again compare with the current root node. As both are equal, we'll say that our search is successful, and hence perform the next step for the deletion of the node having both the child nodes. So the next step is to find out the in order predecessor. So which one is the in order predecessor? We have to take care of in order predecessor. So let's find out the in order predecessor. In order predecessor, for that here we will check for the in order predecessor, and here you can see that in order predecessor is 85. For 85, what we have to do, we have to replace the delete key with the in order predecessor. So let's replace the key 86, deletion key, with the in order predecessor 85, and after that you have to delete this actual node which was present as a right child of 79, and your tree will look like this. In this way, we can perform the deletion operation on the node which is having both the child nodes. So, thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment, and do not forget to share it with your friends. Here, I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel Tech Talks, along with the next video of this video series, and the whole video series you can find here in the form of playlist. Thank you. Happy data structuring. Happy learning. Thank you.